there's going to be millions of people and thousands of enlightened beings at this place. But there will only be one incarnation. And to go with him and stay with him and be with him through all of the excitement upon excitement upon excitement is just too much of a blessing to miss. I myself have no money at this point. I myself have all these barriers that stand between me and the next Kumbh Mela. But it matters not, because I will be there no matter what. Regardless of whatever stands in the way, I'll walk if I have to. So with that, I just want to express the immensity of what's going to happen.
Basically, through this program, people can call in, get solutions for their problems. We also, pray for their well-being, and so they also can call in and ask for healing, for solutions for whatever problems they may have. And we call them back and ensure that they have been handled properly, and whatever their problems, whatever their requirements, it is all getting sorted out for them. So basically, by this program, there are thousands across the state who are benefiting, they call in and they get clarity about their life.
Immediate solutions they are getting. They don't have to wait. They don't have to go browse website, or they don't have to come here looking for information or something. So immediately sitting at home, they are getting all the information.
And not only that, so we also share a lot of details about various programs that is happening at the ashram, that is happening locally, close by to their homes, in Bangalore and other centers across Karnataka. So where they can go and participate and learn more about the science of enlightenment, the science of just living in bliss.
They can call us all the time, and we'll be available to take their calls. There's a big team in Enriching Temple. We are sitting and receiving calls and assisting people.
By this, actually, it's such a great boon. Swamiji has, through this program, is now reaching out to all the people in their homes. So, Swamiji's presence is there every day, both in the morning and evening, in each viewer's homes. So it is literally his blessings for them on a daily basis. So
lots of gratitude calls also we are getting on the TV, other time at Enriching Temple. So lots of healing is happening, miracles are happening in people's life.
Whoever it is can call us in the mornings, between 7 to 7.30. The program is for an hour, which is from 6.30 to 7.30. But you can call in between 7 to 7.30, and in the evenings, between 5.30 to 6.
So we are going to be using the same blindfold. As you can see, they both have said that they are unable to see anything at all. We are going to be using the same blindfold on the children, and then we will request councilmen to write something on their pad. Or if you have a visiting card on you, councilman, would you have something? You can give your visiting card, and they will read it for you. So, Isha, you have the visiting card. One second, Isha.
Arith Sataj Taj, city council member, Artesia, California, 865-6262.
this is the expression of the third eye. So her, she is blindfolded, yet able to read every single fine print which is on the card. And now Keshav is going to be reading another card for us.
Victor Manalo, PhD, Mayor Pro Tem, Artesia, California, 906262.
Like even in the life of the story of Markandeya, even when he was born, Mahadeva told to his parents that he will be a very intelligent and spiritual kid, but he will live only for 16 years. Then his parents will say okay, and then they'll get a child and he'll be named as Markandeya. Then Markandeya will start, he'll grow very spiritually and very actively and very complete. And on his 16th birthday, when he goes for a blessing to his parents, his mother will like be very sad and like that. Then I'll ask her why you're sad. Then she'll tell that Lord Shiva told that on your 16th birthday, when you're 16 years, you'll just leave the body. Then he will say, I'll pray to Lord Shiva and make sure that I go beyond death itself. Then he goes and sits in the forest and does tapas. And he starts praying and does tapas to Mahadeva. And when he becomes 16, that time Yama comes to take him and go away. So when Yama comes, even at that moment, Markandeya, he said, no, wait, for I'll finish my puja. After I finish my puja to Mahadeva, then you can take me and go. But Yama was like resisting, saying, no, you have to come. I cannot wait for your puja and all. But still Markandeya, he was so authentic and he wanted to decide for life, because his life was just devotion to Mahadeva. So because of that, he just decided for life and hugged on to the Mahadeva's linga. And out of the linga, Mahadeva just came and kicked Yama away and just told, you cannot take my devotee away, he's immortal. So Mahadeva just separates devotees from Yama's death. So what I feel is, even in the last moment, even when death comes, if you decide for life, somehow the cosmos will make your decision for life as the first priority and give what is supposed to be given to you.